With so many different tools coming in the market, it is getting more and more confusing to start your career in data engineering. I get these questions a lot on my channel. Should I first learn Databricks, Snowflake? Should I focus on Airflow? Should I start by learning about Hadoop and many more? Don't worry, in this video, I will take you from the basic level to the advanced level from all of the resources and the skill set you need to become a data engineer. So if I were to put myself in your shoes and start my career in data engineering from the scratch, how would I do it? I will give you a complete framework to start your career in data engineering with 7 different projects. So watch this video till the end to understand each and every step and how you can become a data engineer. I will divide this video into 3 different sections. First section is for the people who are completely new to this field and want to switch their career into data engineering from other fields. Second section is for people who know some basics and want to know how to move forward. Third section is for the people who have some experience and want to grow in their career. You can jump to different sections according to your need, but I will still suggest you to watch this video from start to end to gain more clarity. And at the end of the video, I will give you the complete document where you can learn all of the different skills that we talk in this video. So first, focus on watching and understanding the different skill set, and then I will give you the complete guide on how to become a data engineer by doing different courses, resources and everything. And also let me know in the comments in which section you belong and also what are the different problems that you are facing in order to become a data engineer. Now before we start, it is really important that you have the right mindset. Just by watching this video, you are not going to become a data engineer. You will have to sit in front of your screen every day and learn something from the courses by watching videos, blogs and reading books. It is a complete hard work and it is not going to be easy, but it will be worth definitely at the end. So make sure you focus on building a daily routine of learning. You can spend 2 to 3 hours daily. I generally spend 2 hours in the morning to learn something new. So you can build a routine around it according to your commitments and focus on learning something new every day. So without wasting time, let's get started. You might be one of these people. First, you're working in some non-tech job such as sales and marketing and want to switch your career into tech or mainly data engineering. Second, you are a student or a fresher who did not get a chance to pursue CS degree or your college level education wasn't great. Third, you are working in some other tech job and want to switch your career. It can be anything. The first thing you need to do if you fall in this category is master your computer science fundamentals. You are completely new to this field and before even learning about data engineering, you need to clear your computer science fundamentals. So if you have no idea about what computer science is, then there is this amazing series available on YouTube provided by Harvard, CS50. Just watch this video and you are done. You don't need to get a computer science degree or spend 6 to 8 months learning about computer science fundamentals. You can finish watching this video in 1 to 2 weeks and you are done. The goal here is not to master computer science. The goal here is to get understanding of different terminologies used in computer science, such as data structures, programming languages, how computer understand codes, compilers, and many more things. So once you clear your computer science fundamentals, then we can take 1 step ahead into data engineering world. Here we will focus on learning 3 important skills for data engineering, and these are the fundamental skills required for data engineers. The first thing is learning about programming language. Why learn programming language? Because as a data engineer, you will be writing a lot of transformation jobs, deploying some script, validating and testing them. And for that, you need to master 1 programming language. As a data engineer, you have 3 choices available: Java, Scala and Python. If you know any of these languages, then you are good to go. But if you are a beginner and if you have no idea, then I will suggest you to start with the Python. Python is very easy to learn and understand and the syntax is quite easy. So in 1 to 2 weeks, you can just start writing Python code and get a good head start. And then you can move to second skill that is required for data engineering, that is called as SQL, Structured Query Language. In my career, I have spent most of my time writing SQL queries. The reason is simple. Everything you do online, all of the data gets stored in database. This is generally called as a relational database. So if you consider the case of Amazon, so everything about shipping, order confirmation, your order details, your profile details, every single thing is stored in relational database. And the SQL or SQL is the way we communicate with this database. You can select some data if you want to fetch some data, you can insert some data, you can update or delete some data according to your requirements. These are some of the highly used keywords that I use on day-to-day basis as a data engineer. SQL is the king of data industry. It doesn't matter if you are working as a data analyst, data engineer, data scientist, you will find SQL everywhere because your data is stored inside the database and the SQL is the way how you communicate with the database. And the third and the last fundamental skills required for data engineer is learning about Linux command. Most of the data engineering tasks you will do will be on the remote machine or cloud platforms. All of these machines and the servers generally run on Linux operating system. So it is really important for you to understand how to work with this machine and understand the basic Linux command. Here are the basic Linux command that you can master. Now don't worry about where you can learn all of these things. As I said, I will give you the complete document at the end of this video. So just focus on understanding the skill set right now, and then we will understand how to learn all of these things. So if you're in this stage where you already learn about the basic fundamentals required for data engineering, such as programming language, SQL, Linux command, and tried learning about other data engineering skills but don't know where to go forward from there, then this particular section is for you. At this stage, your goal should be to learn the minimum level skill set required for data engineering and how you can kickstart your career into data engineer. You don't have to spend learning about each and every skills or tools available in the market. You just have to focus on highly demanded and important level skill set required for data engineering on this particular stage. So in this stage, we will focus on building the strong foundation for data engineering. So the first fundamental you need to focus on is understanding data warehouse. So there are basically two parts here. One is learning about data warehouse fundamentals, and one is learning about tools such as Snowflake or BigQuery or other data warehouse available in the market. So data warehouse fundamentals generally include understanding about OLAP versus OLTP, dimension table, extract, transform, load, ER modeling or dimension modeling, such as understanding fact and dimension table. If you like learning from the book, then you can read the Data Warehouse Toolkit by Kimball. This is one of the best book written on data warehouse. So once you learn data warehouse fundamentals, then you can apply all of the things you learn on one particular tool. Now there are many different data warehouses available in the market: Snowflake, BigQuery, Redshift, and many more. So you can pick one data warehouse and go from there. If you want my recommendation, I will suggest you to learn Snowflake, because its demand is increasing day by day and a lot of companies are trying to migrate to Snowflake. Now, once you learn about data storage, such as understanding data warehouse fundamentals, then you also need to understand the data processing frameworks. Now, generally, there are two processing frameworks. One is batch processing, second is real-time processing. Batch processing basically means if you want to process your data in batches, if you want to process last month of data once a day or twice a day, this is basically called as batch processing, because we are processing the entire batch of data in one time and then getting some output at the end. Second is real-time streaming, which is basically, as the name suggests, the data is coming in real time. So if you have used apps such as Uber or Google, you get the output of everything in real time basis. So for this, we also have some frameworks and tools available in the market. For batch processing, most of the companies uses Apache Spark. Apache Spark is an open source framework for data processing. So first you can start by learning Apache Spark fundamentals, and then you can learn a tool that powers Apache Spark environment. That can be Databricks, AWS EMR, GCP Dataproc, or any of the tool you find on the market. My suggestion for you is to practice Spark on Databricks, and the language you should use is PySpark. You can write Spark code in various different languages, Scala, Java, and Python, but as we already learned Python, you can use PySpark, which is kind of like a layer on top of the Spark environment, and write your code in Python syntax, so you don't have to learn about new language from the scratch. So if you already know the Python, then focus on writing your Spark code in PySpark. So if you're understanding the way we are learning, is we are breaking down different problems into smaller chunks. First, we focus on learning about fundamentals, and then we learn one highly demanded tool in the market that you can apply your fundamental knowledge on top of it. This is one of the best way I learned when I was learning about data engineering, is focusing on the fundamentals and then deep diving into topic. If you like this approach, then let me know in the comments. So for the batch processing, we are focusing on Apache Spark. For the stream processing, we also have many frameworks, but we can focus on learning about Apache Kafka. Apache Kafka is a distributed event store and stream processing platform, so you can process your data in real time. All of the things we talked about, storage and data processing, is done on cloud platforms. So the third skill you need to master is learning about cloud platforms. Generally, you have three choices available: Azure, AWS, and Google Cloud Platform. I started my career with AWS, but you can pick any cloud platform, because once you learn one cloud, then you can easily master any other cloud. When I learned about AWS and when I wanted to learn about Google Cloud Platform, it was very easy for me to migrate, because all of the services on the fundamentals are same. Just the UI is different, the cost might be different, and all of the other things. But the fundamental concept of all of these cloud platforms are same. So just focus on one cloud platform. If you want, you can start with AWS and then see how it goes. So in data engineering, you have to create the data pipelines to process your data. So your data is coming in relational database. You want to apply some transformation or business logic, and then you want to put that data on some target location. Now this is generally called as a data pipeline or ETL pipeline. and these operations are done using workflow management tools. One of the highly workflow management tool is Airflow, so you can learn about Airflow. I also have the project on Airflow. Don't worry about it, we will discuss about the projects and resources at the end of this video. So if you learn all of these skills, you are basically a data engineer, because you already understood about the storage, processing, some data pipeline frameworks, and your fundamentals are clear. So at this stage, you are a data engineer. Now, learning does not end here. There are so many different tools available, new approaches, and the tools are coming in the market. So you need to stay updated and learn about all of those too. On top of that, you also need to learn about how to design the entire data infrastructure, how to architect system. And for that, you need some advanced level skill set that we will talk about on section 3. In this section, you already know the intermediate level data engineering skills. You have done some projects, and then you want to understand how to learn about the advanced level skills required for data engineering. So the first thing I recommend you to explore is modern data stack. Here are the list of tools that you can learn more about it. Explore these different tools, understand what they do and why do we even need them on the first place. You don't need to get attached to all of these different tools. Just understand the core use case of that tool and you are good to go, because when you actually need it, then you can spend more time learning about tools. One tool I highly suggest you to explore is DBT. Data build tool, because a lot of people are talking about this tool in the market and many companies are also using it. So I will highly recommend you to focus on DBT for now and then also explore some other data tools available in the market. Problem here is that most of the people are attached to the old way of doing things, such as traditional way of processing things, and they don't generally welcome these new tools coming in the market. But market keeps moving forward, so you also need to upgrade yourself and have the adaptability of learning and understanding all of these tools. Now this was just understanding the one side, which is understanding about the tool. Second side is understanding about the security, networking, deployment, and all of the different things. So you can also learn about Docker or Kubernetes. So when you create your data pipeline and write some transformation job, then if you want to deploy them in production, this is where the Docker and Kubernetes comes into the picture. Here are the two books that I suggest if you want to read more about the data system. One is reading Designing Data Intensive Applications. I've read this book so many times. I found this book so helpful that I ordered the actual physical copy of it, but you can go online and find the ebook. If you find the ebook, you can comment it out. Second book you can read is Fundamentals of Data Engineering. I've already read this book and it is one of the best book I've read on data engineering. So if you want, you can go online, buy it, or if you find the e-copy, then you can also read it from there. So reading these books, you will get more understanding. And after that, you also need to learn about some customer case studies. So you can go to platforms such as AWS and GCP. They have a lot of customer success case studies. They had some data engineering problem and how they use different services or tools to solve those problems. So reading all of those case studies will give you better understanding of how to use this system in real world, make you the senior staff engineer or data architect. Because the more you focus on solving problems by understanding different technologies, the more ahead you get. So in summary, if I want to start my data engineering career from the scratch, first I will focus on the basic level skill sets such as understanding programming language, computer science fundamentals, SQL and Linux. Then I will jump onto the big data level fundamentals such as understanding data warehouses, data processing frameworks such as Spark and Kafka, and understand about the cloud platforms and Airflow, and then I can explore some other tools and methodologies available in the market. So this is how I will become a data engineer. Now here's the sheet I was talking about. I have created the complete path that you can follow. These are the different courses available. I've also given the projects after learning each and every skill set. I've also added some book recommendation and case studies that you can explore. Again, go through this sheet step by step. If you already have some skills, you can skip and focus on the important part that you are missing. This should take around 6 to 8 months depending on your skill set level and how fast you learn. Spend every day at least 1 to 2 hours learning something new. Even if it is difficult, even if you don't understand anything, stay consistent and focus on learning every day. So this was all about this video. So if you found this video helpful, then make sure you hit the like button. This helps this channel to grow and reach more and more people. And if you want to join the data engineering journey, I keep publishing different projects, tutorials, and many more different things on my channel. So you can subscribe to my channel if you want more of this content. And thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next video.